And everybody should know that's how love goes. It's good for the soul.
Oh, I got a long way to go, but it won't stop the pain. No, that's the kind of thing that keeps me coming back again and again.
Jazz legend. Nobody is better than him. Kind of like me on the basketball court. Music lovers are lucky to have him, and Lakeside Prep is lucky to have me.
So it sounds like you're saying improvisation is making it up as you go along.
Well, that's right. It's making it up as you go along. But it's also improving things as you go along. Improve, improvise. So you have a basic idea, and you add more of your personality to the idea. You play around with it, you stretch it, you extend it, you shave off some things. It's a matter of intelligence, wit, and timing. And from what I understand, you need some help with your timing. Because you've been running around here giving some extremely corny lines to these young ladies. So you need to know about improvisation.
Why don't you play us another one, Mr. Marcelli?
Well, Coach, I want to play another one. And I want to personally thank you for calling me and inviting me to come down and meet these beautiful youngsters. But we have a benefit for music in the schools that we're going to be doing at Groove Theory. I want you all to invite your family and friends to get some tickets so that we can have music for everyone. Then I'm going to play that other one for you.
All right. Andrew.
How do you
good do? To see you. Good to see you.
Good to see you.
Excuse me.
Mm-hmm.
Mr. Ben Adams here.
He's over there.
Thank you. Miss one.
Mr. Lester.
Hey. Boy, how many times I got to tell you to call me Hardy, huh? Come here.
Yeah, I see you back on your feet.
You better believe it. Son, you did a good job running my store.
I told you I would.
Well, folks will tell you anything when they come see you in the nursing home. Yeah, you made more J&H than it was. Made more yourself, too. Look at you.
I'm doing all right.
I'm glad to see that was just a rumor about you managing my store with flats in your head.
Wait, what, you got spies now?
That's right.
Yeah, well, I had braids, but I took them out.
Well, good for you. Fine shame a grown man running around with a woman's hairdo.
Yeah. I got to talk to you about some business, Mr. Lester.
Wait. Let's go in the back. Don't talk in front of customers. It's bad for business.
All right, what's going on? I'm not going to be running the store anymore. And I already gave the family 30 days notice.
Oh, wait a minute, son. We got a deal. Man don't walk out on a deal now.
Yeah, but it's time for me to move on.
Hey, wait. Now, I gave you a chance.
when your so-called family thought you wasn't worth shit. I gave you my store.
And I appreciate it. Every time I put the key in that lock, every time somebody calls me Mr. Van Adams, I appreciate it.
Listen to me, boy. Now, I want you to think on this some more. Now, I'm gonna get my house in order, and I will call you later. Hmm?
Good practice, boys. Nice one. Good. Don't forget those drills.
All right, Coach.
Good practice, boys.
Coach Robinson, I have to miss our first game.
What's the problem?
They changed the qualifier exams for the Academic Olympics. Sorry.
Don't be sorry for me. Be sorry for yourself.
You're kicking me off the team?
No, that's not what I meant. Let me tell you something. Black folks need options in this world, son. Now, if you're not born rich, you have to create those options. Athletics gives you one more way to do that.
Is that how you got to college?
Yeah, Georgetown.
Yeah, Iverson School.
Iverson. Before the answer, there was the poker.
The poker?
You try to cover me too tight, I put your eye out. Yeah, boy, that was a great school. I got a solid education and I met lifelong friends. None of that would have happened without basketball.
I want to play, but I've been getting ready for the Academic Olympics for months. And my mama started tripping.
Tell you what, I'll work it out for you. Arrange for you to make up the exam, that way you can play in the game and still take the exam.
Thanks.
No problem. Just don't you forget about me when you're hooping it up at Georgetown.
What? I never do you like that, Coach Robinson. I'd at least wait until I'm in the NBA before I start forgetting folks.
All right, I'll call him back later. Okay. Yeah, I'm just picking up Ahmad. Okay, great. Thanks, Gloria.
Teri.
What are you doing here?
Picking up Ahmad? I'm taking him to a soccer game.
Oh. Well, nobody told me. I always pick him up on Thursdays.
I remember. Sorry, I assumed Max would call you.
Well, she didn't. Goodbye.
Do you want to come with us?
No, thank you.
How long are you going to treat me like this?
Like what, Damon?
Never mind. Forget it.
You know, you were the one who screwed up, remember?
Of course I remember.
And I said I'm sorry over and over again.
I'm sorry doesn't change what happened, does it?
No, it doesn't.
Okay.
But I'd hoped it would give us a chance.
There is no us, Damon.
Good. But if it's over, it's over. And you need to get your stuff out of my place. Then we can both move on.
How about this weekend?
I'll be out of town. You can come by next week.
Bye.
Bye, Aunt Teri.
Bye.
Hey, Damon.
Hey.
So. And you coming to the game with us?
No, your mom forgot to tell me that you had other plans today. So call me later. Tell me who won.
Okay.
Let's do this, man. Come on. You straight?
Yeah.
Everything cool?
Yeah.
How's your girl?
Hey, Freddy called me and said you was here. What's up? Mm-hmm.
Well, let's wait for your brother-in-law to arrive. I only want to say what I got to say once.
Hey, I got your message, man. What's so urgent?
I actually got Mr. Lester's message. He's got something to say.
That's right. And I didn't want those Joseph sisters around when I said it.
All right, Len, what is this all about?
Hey.
I think us men should run the store.
You know that's not going to work, Hardy. When the women find out we even had this meeting, they'll have a fit.
Then don't tell them what happened. Be a man about it. Just tell them how it's going to be.
Mr. Lester.
Oh, no, wait a minute. The last thing I want to bring my wife and her sisters are more problems. You know, they have been through enough already this year.
Those women don't go through hell. They put men through it.
Fact is, Hardy, you agreed legally to sell us the store if we allowed you to stay here 3 more months. Now, it's because of that damn heart attack we allowed you to stay here longer.
Let me tell you something, son. If you want a bunch of women to start running you, why don't you just put a collar around your neck and let them feed you, and they want to, too.
Oh, come on now. We really
and you make me sick. All this time running the store, and you still a lapdog. Running around these women and lapping up their bullshit. And co-signing his.
You know, thank you for stopping by, Hardy.
Lapdog! Get out of my way.
Hey, baby, do me a favor. Set the table for me, please.
Okay. Thank you.
Hey, what time do you need to leave for your academic Olympics exams on Saturday?
I don't, but I have a basketball game at 2 o'clock.
Hey, family.
In here, Ahmad. You're not playing basketball instead of doing the academic Olympics.
I know. Coach Robinson fixed it so I can make up the exams. He wants me to create options for myself with basketball.
Babe, you hear this?
No, honey. I just walked through the door, remember?
Ahmad's basketball coach arranged for him to get out of exams so he can play basketball.
What?
I don't know about you, but I did not fill out 1,000 forms and sit on a waiting list for 3 years to get vouchers for Ahmad to play basketball.
Mm-hmm. You know, why can't I do both?
Well, you probably can, son, but that's a decision for us to make, not your basketball coach.
Exactly.
Yeah. Look, I'm gonna take a shower.
Okay.
All right.
What's it say?
It says, to Terry Joseph. Oh.
Sorry about yesterday.
Thought we were on the same page regarding Ahmad's education.
We were, and we still are.
Then how would you explain a teacher telling our son that he would help him find a way to put basketball before his studies, telling him that as a black man, he needs to pursue sports?
I can't comment on what Mr. Robinson said until I talk to him. However, I can assure you that our goals are identical. Education will always be first at Lakeside Prep. Especially for Ahmad, who is quickly becoming one of our brightest lights.
Well, that's good to hear.
Yes, it is.
Now, if you don't mind, I'd like to table this discussion until I get a chance to do a little research.
All right. Well, thank you for your time.
Pleasure.
Okay.
Thank you.
Pleasure.
I need you to talk to me from a male perspective.
About Damon?
Yeah.
May I say something before we get started on this again?
Again? Never mind.
Oh, come on, don't be like that.
I'm not being like anything, Brian. Let me remind you, you're the one who told me to call if I needed to talk. Now, if you don't feel comfortable with that, I can pay a shrink and not get attacked for the effort.
If you're waiting for me to say you should get back with him...
I'm not asking you to say that.
Good. Because the guy's a jerk, Terry. I mean, he knew how hard it was for you to finally be okay with being in a relationship with him. And he did what he did anyway.
He asked me to get my things out of his apartment.
Well, if you really want this to be over, maybe you should. Look, I know it's not easy to hear this. Believe me, I've been there.
No, you haven't.
Of course I have. Breaking up's hard, even for me. I mean, you leave some of your belongings over at your ex's place, or they leave their stuff at yours. Gives you an excuse to visit. 9 times out of 10, you're in for a few rounds of makeup sex.
Makeup sex?
Tell me you don't know what that is.
I guess I'm not. Shit. I had sex with Miles and that our divorce was final.
Right then.
Oh, God. And I know you're right. I have to get my things from Damon.
Hey,
Doing your homework, huh?
Chemistry.
Oh, where's your test tube and your Bunsen burner?
In the lab. Sometimes Dad can be extra corny.
You know, son, I wanted to talk to you a quick second about basketball.
Okay.
Yeah?
Yeah.
All right. Now, I know you love the game.
Mm-hmm.
And we really don't mind you playing, all right? But I just don't want you to get excited about your chances, son. You know what I mean?
No.
Well, basketball players are tall. And you're not really.
Ricky was the same height as me last year, and now he's 6 feet.
Well, his father is 6'3". And your father is 5'10".
Maybe I'll take after mom's side of the family.
Son.
Even if I don't, what about Muggsy Bowles?
Well, he's just one in a million. And I don't want you building your life on those kind of odds. Now, when I was your age, the only thing I ever wanted in life was to run like Gale Sayers.
Who's that?
The greatest running back of all time.
Even better than Barry Sanders was?
Oh, much. You know, my best friend used to arrange chairs in his basement for me. Yeah, and he would lead me down there blindfolded, right? He would take off the blindfold, and I would run full speed straight through the room, dodging all the furniture, you know, trying to learn how to cut like Gale says. But I couldn't. Because God only created one man on earth that could cut like that. But son, there was still 1,001 things that I could do. You understand what I'm saying?
Yep. Coach Robinson believes in me and you don't. Yes.
All right. Well,
I have to finish this.
Yeah, all right then.
Because I got up and unlocked it when you called and said you were 3 minutes away.
Ah. Brooke asleep?
Yeah. She's been napping for about an hour.
Oh, I better get her up.
Come on. Can I talk to you for a minute first?
Sure.
Kelly, baby, go pack up your stuff.
Okay.
What's up?
I went to pick up Ahmad yesterday. It turns out he was double booked.
Shit.
Yeah. Shit.
I'm sorry.
Sorry that you forgot to tell me not to pick him up? Or sorry you forgot to tell me that my family has an ongoing relationship with my ex-boyfriend?
Well, we didn't think you would mind. You're the one who encouraged the relationship between them.
Come on, Maxine.
Come on what? Ahmad loves Damon. He loves soccer since Damon introduced him to it. And he's damn near fluent in French thanks to Damon's help.
Well, I'll hire Ahmad another tutor.
What's wrong with you?
From now on, when I divorce a husband or break up with a boyfriend or get rid of the guy who delivers my bottled water, I'd appreciate it if my family also severed ties with that man.
Got it.
Good.
Hurry up, Kelly, honey. Your auntie needs to get some rest.
Babe, you still in bed?
Hardy Lester's back.
What?
Yep, he came by the store twice. He wants us, me and him, to run the store together.
Well, did you remind him that he signed a contract selling us his half of the store?
He doesn't care. I mean, the store's all he's got. He acts like it's his kid or something.
Teri is gonna flip when she hears this. And I'm the one who begged her not to enforce the contract until after Uncle Hardy recovered from his heart attack. You expected somebody?
Nope.
Lemben Adams?
Yeah.
You're served. Have a nice day.
What is it?
Party soon to get his half of the store back.
Oh, my, what? This is unbelievable.
Miss Joseph, so nice to see you again.
Oh, thank you. It's nice to see you. Can I get you anything?
Your assistant already offered. I'm fine, thank you. So, I gather that you'd like to make a settlement offer. I must warn you, though, I don't have much wiggle room.
You are seriously going to contest Hardy's contract for sale of J&H Groceries on the grounds that he was mentally unfit?
He was and is.
Oh, come on. Hardy Lester has no history of mental illness.
None that you're aware of. Hey, I can make a definitive showing in court.
Yeah. You're going to make a definitive fool of yourself.
Oh, please, look, are you going to make a settlement offer or not?
This is the most ridiculous bluff I've ever seen.
Good day, Miss Joseph.
Good day, Mr. Shard.
You got Mr. Robinson fired.
But Mr. Robinson was fired?
Because of you and Mom.
Who told you that?
Mr. Robinson.
Look, Ahmad, your mother and I did not have that man fired.
Then why would he tell me that?
Look, we talked to the principal. We didn't say anything about firing him.
I can't believe my dad doesn't know what he did.
I hope that look doesn't mean you don't believe your own father.
I don't.
So Uncle Hardy claims he's too crazy to sell us the store?
Well, look, if someone signs a contract when they're not in their right mind, the contract is voidable. You know, so Hardy claims he goes in and out of this psychological fugue where he's not really conscious and he doesn't remember what he did when he was in it.
If I knock some sense into his head, I bet he remember that.
Well, that'll help, Maxine.
Hey. What if this is just a lawyer talking? Uncle Hardy might not even know he's saying these things.
Like hell he doesn't, Bird. The man will say anything. Next, it'll be Hardy joining the circus, and clowns gotta run the store.
Well, look, I don't believe Uncle Hardy knows his lawyer's defense is this silly. I'm gonna go talk to him.
You can't.
Why not?
Because you might say something that would help his case, and then his lawyers will be able to call you as a witness.
I'm not gonna hurt the case.
Bird, will you listen to Teri, please?
Look, I will get an expert witness to discredit him. We'll beat this in court.
Uncle Hardy might not be completely healed after the heart attack. I want to see if I can go talk him out of this.
Bird, no.
We didn't say anything about wanting that man fired.
I don't know.
He was the only black teacher at that school.
Mm-hmm.
How did we know something like this was gonna happen?
Mm. Well, we couldn't, baby. But we have to go back down to that school and tell Principal Gordon how we feel. Yeah.
Uncle Hardy, this is silly. When you signed those papers, you were in your right mind and you know it.
Papers? What papers?
We had a deal.
Deal? I don't remember no deal. What was your name again?
You know Gunwell is Bird.
Bird? What kind of name is that?
The kind you gave me when I was 7 years old, remember? Girl, how can you walk around here on those skinny little legs? You look like a bird. You gonna tell me you were crazy back then?
I'm gonna have to beg your pardon, see, because I don't remember real good. I got this condition.
Oh, you stop. You and I both know you don't have no condition.
I do. It's called a fugue state. See, what happens is every time...
You don't have any kind of fugue state or any other state, and you know it.
Well, look here, I'd like to help you, but I'm sorry. I'm sorry. What you say your name is?
You are sorry. If that's how you want to act, you know what? Fine. Goodbye, Uncle Hardy. Hope you can remember to pay for breakfast.
Hello? Hello. Hi. I'm sorry I didn't mean to scare you. I thought Damon was out of town.
He is out of town. Went to visit his brother. I just came by to water the plants. Bring in the mail.
Excuse me. I feel like I have to say this.
If you tell me that you guys are together, it's going to upset me. If you tell me you guys are just friends, it is going to upset me.
Why would it upset you to hear that we're friends?
Because we both know that that's just a game. You hang around, water his plants, pick up his mail, maybe even cook him a meal every now and then. And then the next thing you know, you and your good friend are fucking. A regular happy couple.
I'm not playing any games, Teri.
Then what else would you call fucking a man you know has a girlfriend?
I'd call it two adults making a decision to do something they both wanted to do.
I could think of a few other things to call it. And you.
Why don't I come back when you're done?
Why don't you?
We've complained more than once about Mrs. O'Donnell restricting bathroom breaks, Mr. Wiley yelling. Neither one of them were let go. Why is it there's one complaint about a black teacher and he's gone?
I don't like what you're implying.
All we want is to be clear on Lakeside Prep giving priority to academics with Ahmad, just as you would with any of your other students, whether they were athletically talented or not.
I'm afraid it's not that simple. What you described was illegal racial discrimination.
What we thought we were describing was a teacher's misguided philosophy.
Maybe you were, but that philosophy was full of racial bias.
Mr. Gordon, we can go around and around like this all day, or we can try and quickly come to an understanding. We just want you to reconsider your decision.
If a subsequent incident occurs where Mr. Robinson is accused of illegal racial preference, the school would be liable. Because thanks to you, I have foreknowledge. It is unfortunate. I appreciate your regrets.
Could I talk to you for a minute? I wish you'd talk to me before you talk to the principal. Don't need to talk now. I'm fired.
Look, now I promise this is not what we wanted to happen.
Promises won't pay my bills, Mr. Chadway.
Look, this is not all on us. Now, you should have come and talked to me and my wife before you talked to our son.
I am a teacher and a coach. You pay me to talk to your kids.
Now, I don't pay you to tell my son that he needs to play basketball in order to have a future.
I never said that. I told him that basketball would increase his options. As a young black man, he's going to need as many options as he can get.
Well, you can't seriously believe that at his height, basketball is one of those options.
It might be. At the college level, Ivy League schools love student athletes. So if he develops his skills...
Develop false hopes with them. and squander away time that could have been productive.
Yeah, well, that's your opinion based on a very narrow perspective, Mr. Chadway. Now, I've been dealing with rich white folks and their educational systems a long time. And quite frankly, this world is new to you and your wife. So you might consider that perhaps my opinion is a little more valid here.
Yeah, well, my opinion is the one that counts here. Because Ahmad is my son.
You're gonna have to lower your voice.
Look, I don't have to do shit, man.
All right, but I will. Okay, because I didn't come down here to fight. I came down here because a brother got a bad break. And I'm sorry that I had to be a part of it. Maybe we can still work this out, all right? And my wife is down there talking to Mr. Gordon right now.
Oh, man, get real. You can't go to my boss and complain that I'm treating your son differently because he's black, then go back and tell him to take me back because I'm black.
I guess you're right. So you should have no problem finding a new job teaching since you know everything.
Hello?
Damon?
Hey.
Hey, welcome home. I picked up your mail. And I thought, since I know you don't like airplane food, you might be a little hungry.
I am. You didn't have to cook for me.
Well, I did. But I can't stay, so you sit. Teri was here when I came by this morning.
What? In here? Why?
She's picking up her things. I told her that I was just taking care of the plants, but...
Did she seem upset?
Yeah, I think so.
She shouldn't have seen you here.
Well, I'm sorry.
Why were you here anyway?
Because you asked me to be, remember? I was doing you a favor.
Yeah, no. Chrissy, I'm sorry.
I need to go work out.
Well, please stay.
No, I think I should go.
I really want you to stay. Please. Thank you. Come back from Cambridge. She was getting my mail, watering my plants, that's it.
Would you excuse me for a second? Necessary.
There's no reason for me to keep it.
Well, you can throw it away because I had the locks changed. Now, if you don't mind, I have work to do.
What good would it do me to mind?
How you feeling?
Like shit.
I just wanted you to see what you won't be getting anymore.
Well, why don't I get dressed so we can talk?
Oh, oh God, don't!
Don't do it! Don't do it!
Oh, God!
Don't! Hello.
Hi.
Who is this?
It's Teri. I'm sorry to call you so late.
I'm awake. What's wrong?
I didn't give you your key back.
Oh, it's all right.
No, it isn't. I could messenger it over tomorrow.
Okay.
Damon.
Yes?
Was I that horrible to be with?
What are you talking about? Every minute we were together was cool. Even when we were fighting.
Then why didn't you love me enough to be faithful?
What happened between me and her had nothing to do with how much I love you.
I don't know, maybe I shouldn't have told you about it.
Well, I'm glad you did. Good luck, Damon, with everything.
I love you, Miss Joseph.
Bye, Mr. Carter.
I'll get right to the point. I asked you to come to my chambers because I am pulling your case from the docket.
May I ask why, Your Honor?
My court is not a circus tent, Mr. Shard.
I'm afraid I have to take issue.
Don't bother. There's nothing you can say to convince me to allow this psycho bullshit in my courtroom.
Thank you, Your Honor.
I have an expert witness.
Quit while you're ahead, counsel. I've half a mind to hit you with sanctions for filing such a frivolous cause of action and wasting the court's time.
What wasted time? This is my life we're talking about here.
Hardy, please, I can handle this.
Oh, I see how you're handling it.
And I see your modus operandi, Mr. Lester. The record shows a pattern of deceit aimed at frustrating a prior court's lawful decision. Therefore, I am rejecting your request to void the contract for sale of your interest in J&H Groceries.
Well, along those lines, Your Honor, I submit Mr. Lester has forced my clients to wait long enough. I will offer a cashier's check for the contracted amount and move for performance of the sale.
Let's have it.
Wait a minute.
Mr. Shard.
Your Honor, can I say something here, please?
Sure, if you want to go to jail. Works for me. I declare Mr. Lester's interest in the store conveyed to the respondent.
No.
Josephs, Chadways, and Van Adams are granted full ownership of J&H Groceries.
Thank you, Your Honor.
That's it. Have a nice day.
This is not right, Your Honor. Mate, listen, I've been a sick man, you know, and I would never have
Hardy,
signed
Hardy,
this contract.
Enough.
Wait a minute.
Take it outside, Mr.
Hardy,
Lester.
Hardy, enough.
What?
Enough,
what?
Enough,
but enough. We'll do something. Just don't let this happen.
No, enough.
Oh, Lord, I should have hired me a black lawyer from the beginning. It would never happen.
Good morning. Thank you.
Damon.
Hey, Brian. How are you?
Good, good. Can I talk to you for a sec?
Yeah, sure.
Come on in. I didn't know you were delivering here again.
Yeah, it just started. The company wanted to transfer me back, and since Terry isn't here anymore, I didn't see a problem with it.
That makes sense.
So what's up?
Well, I don't know quite how to say this, so I'm just going to spit it out. If you really care about Terry, maybe you should just leave her alone for a while.
Since you just spit it out, I'll do the same. Don't approach me about me and Terry again.
Terry's my friend. And we've been friends a lot longer than she was your girlfriend. So when I see her hurting, Damon, of course it concerns me.
You seem a little overly concerned to me. Maybe you're trying to turn this long-term friendship into something else.
Thanks for your time, man.
Okay. Have a good day.
Thank you.
Thank you very, very much. Thank you. Thank you very much. I'd like to thank y'all once again for coming out here tonight. And before we leave, we'd like to recognize two members of Chicago's 100 black businessmen who are responsible for us coming here tonight. Talking about Wayne Barrett and John Robinson.
Thank you. Thank you. My pleasure.
All right. We got time for one more, a sweet, wistful one. Thank you.
Be back.
Where's he going?
Let him go, Maxine.
Dad is always telling me that part of being a man means that you have to own up to it when you're wrong. But since he can't be a man about Coach getting fired, I will.
Hey, Coach.
Hey, Chadway. So you still getting that?
Trying. I'm sorry about everything.
No, don't be.
But my parents got you.
Look, son, you are not responsible for the actions of others. None of us are. Besides, I'm gonna be all right. Hey, Chadway. Whatever you end up doing, you're gonna be the best at it.
Thanks. Why didn't Coach fight back? Why didn't Principal Gordon not listen to my mom and dad? And why didn't I figure out how to do basketball in the Academic Olympics on my own?
Top of the world. And we was. Two Negroes with their own business. Yes, sir. Ain't that right, Jeremiah? Yeah. Sure wish things were easy with us. Like they were back then. Gone. Messed everything up.
Nothing but an old fool. Nothing. Nothing.
Thank you.